Hey guys, today is December 3rd, 2010, and it's time for another chicken update video. Okay, so these guys have been in pretty much all week. You know, by the time I get home, they're already in their coop, ready for bed. The good news is that the younger girls, these white ones here and the three others, they all started laying eggs already. So we're getting probably about one egg a day. They're a little smaller than they should be, but I hear the first ones definitely come out small. You can see how they kind of like play right now. They're challenging each other and they're running around, I think because they enjoy being outside of the coop area there. They kind of like walking around in here. It's almost like a treat for them. So they kind of get spooked a little bit, you know, if they see a bird go overhead and they all run towards the side. This is Mama right here. So I only have Mama and Spencer, who's the father, left for rabbits. Kind of concerns me when I look at Mama underneath her neck there. You see there's a large clump of fur right there. You can see it. And that typically means that she's going to have babies. So I'm keeping my fingers crossed. I think that's maybe because she's already had a couple litters already. And maybe because it's winter time, she's kind of getting thicker fur, bigger fur. So let's keep our fingers crossed on that. We don't want any more babies. They are digging another hole though, so let me bring you inside the coop. So the last video we did, I showed you about the top area here, and I don't know if you can notice, a lot is different. Basically, the other day it started raining out. And the whole plastic PVC, which is right down here on the ground, the elbows and the pipes and whatnot, basically inverted inside here. So the water on one side, on this side here, was accumulating on the top there. It wasn't going anywhere. And it just kind of, if you think of like the ribs that were here before, it turned the ribs inside out. So it was kind of bowed down in here, you know, backwards. And it really kind of ripped the tarp, and you know, as it's falling, I'm standing here, and it was right after work, and I was jabbing the tarp over here where it was accumulating with a pen, because I didn't have a knife on me to try to get all that water out of there before it collapsed. But it did collapse. I got to get it back up again. I'm going to glue the pipes in, and I'm also going to provide like a center wooden support beam. So the PVC has a wooden support beam to sit on to make it more rigid and strong. It is pretty cold out here in Connecticut this time of year. Really windy where we are, so it's only going to get colder, so I have to take care of this probably this weekend. It takes a few people to do this too. It's not really something that I could do easily by myself. So here's the other hole that they're digging, and that's the second one. It's over by the food area here, and you can see, actually she just walked up right behind me. You see all this dirt here that's not supposed to be there. You can kind of see she pushes it right out here. If I lift this bucket here, you can kind of see the see how much she's brought out there. So She's really digging down there. Now, it could be because of a couple things. The water was raining out so hard that something broke through over here. I was standing right here, and my foot kind of went down in here, and it pushed through to something. I'm guessing the original tunnels that are down here underneath pretty much probably dug out this whole area in the corner here. So there's probably tunnels all underneath this coop area here. I also noticed here on this side, that's Penny right there. Penny, she's the salmon feverel chicken. So I also noticed here on this side here I was standing, and that hole goes right down in there as well. So that broke through. I could just imagine what's underneath that supporting post for the coop area, and thinking maybe the whole coop will go under. I really don't know. I do know that they haven't gotten out of the enclosed area, or at least doesn't appear that way right now. So I think they're hitting the fence and they're kind of stopping. They're not going anywhere, which is good. Water and food is the same as before. Pretty much all the same. The rabbit poop. So there's a lot of rabbit poop. And we had 14 rabbits in here. It accumulated so bad that I had to shovel it out. But it's becoming a challenge, because rabbit poop gets mushy and you can step on it and it kind of smears. Chickens, it's kind of easy to pick up chicken poop. It's not as bad. I think rabbits kind of get mushy more. I don't know. So anyway, let's throw, for the end of the video here, let's throw a couple grapes out. These girls are anxiously awaiting. I don't really have a wide angle screen on this here. Let's see if we can do it this way here. Good girlies. Huh? Good girls. Yeah. All right, get off. All right, come on, get off. So I picked this one up. She lets me pick her up every... This is one of the younger ones here. This is Miss Tessmacher, and she's one of the younger ones. She hangs out with the older ones. Maybe she matured quicker, I don't know. But she lets me pick her up, and we play, and she's a cutie. Alright guys, take care. Hope you enjoyed the video. Talk to you again soon. Bye. Okay, I just wanted to go over their names again and actually give a challenge to you guys. I'm looking for one more name. So that one right there, that's the name is Penny. So she is the salmon faverel. This one here, her name is Miss Tessmacher. She's the dark Cornish. This one right here, her name is Susie. She's the partridge rock. And that one right there, her name is Roosevelt. She's the light Brahma. She has the feathers on her legs right there. And this one here, see, this one's the fifth one. It's almost the exact one as Roosevelt there, but it doesn't have hair on the legs. So I don't know what breed it is. Could it be a light Brahma with no hair on its legs, or a different type? I really don't know. Are they that similar in appearance, but could be... different breeds. Anyway, what's her name? Somebody give me a name for her. Now this chicken, just to let you know, her personality, she's more of the security guard person. When something comes up and something's not right in the coop, when the cat comes in, she kind of runs out, and she's not the most dominant, but she seems like the trooper, like the security guard. So if you can give me a name for her, we'll make it that name, and she'll have that name. So give me a name for her. What should we call her? All right, guys. Thanks for watching again. Talk to you soon. Bye.